everybody, welcome back to another video de AmigosIngleses.com. How are you, Isabel?
I'm good, thanks. And you, Philip?
I'm very well, thank you. ¿Y qué vamos a hacer en este video?
En este video vamos a enseñaros algo muy útil. Bueno, son excusas para cuando lleguéis tarde. Los españoles, bueno, ya sabéis que no somos muy famosos por nuestra puntualidad como los ingleses. Entonces, igual os van a venir bastante bien estas frases.
Para los españoles, seguro. Entonces, vamos a ver tres conversaciones en la calle. Empezamos con la primera conversación.
Hi, Isabel. Sorry I'm late. My alarm didn't go off and I overslept. Sorry.
Okay, don't worry. Just don't do it again, okay? I've only been here for 10 minutes.
Good. I'm not usually late.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, so did you hear those phrases? The first one was...
My alarm didn't go off.
El phrasal verb go off, ¿qué significa?
Bueno, en el caso de la alarma, ¿no? Significa sonar.
My alarm went off at 7 o'clock this morning, for example. Go off es para alarmas o incluso una bomba puede explotar. Go off. So, podrías decir, the bomb went off, for example. What time did your alarm go off this morning, Isabel?
Well, it always goes off half an hour before I actually get up.
Yes.
So I think maybe 6 o'clock, but I ended up getting up at 6:30.
And what time does your alarm go off? Y después dije...
My alarm didn't go off and I overslept.
I overslept. ¿Qué significa oversleep?
Yeah, significa quedarse dormido. Pero cuando te levantas como... Oh, no, tenía que estar en el trabajo. Ahora. No, me he quedado dormido. Yeah, so in English, I've overslept.
Oh, no! It's a horrible feeling, no? When you oversleep.
When you get up and you look at the clock and you are supposed to be at work in 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And then...
That's a horrible feeling. Okay, so vamos a ver la segunda conversación en la calle.
Isabel, sorry I'm late. Sorry, I had to wait ages for the bus and the traffic was terrible. Have you been waiting long?
Well, yes. Since the time we arranged to meet, 6 o'clock, I've been here, so 1 hour now.
Sorry.
I hope you have a good excuse for this.
Well, as I said, the bus. The bus was late. And the traffic was really bad. Come on, I'll get you a drink.
Well, make sure it doesn't happen again, okay?
No, it won't happen again.
If it happens again, you will be in deep trouble.
Sorry, it won't happen again. Come on.
Okay then.
Okay, so did you hear those excuses? The first excuse was...
I had to wait ages for the bus.
¿Qué significa?
Significa que tuviste que esperar mucho tiempo, siglos.
Yeah.
¿No?
Siglos, but siglos en inglés sería centuries.
Yeah.
Pero no decimos centuries, we say ages.
Yeah, no es una traducción literal, pero la expresión que se usa en español es si tuve
siglos.
Que esperar siglos, o por ejemplo, puedes decir no he ido al cine en siglos, ¿no?
Yeah.
How would you say that in English?
You would say I haven't been to the cinema for ages.
Yeah. Significa mucho tiempo, ¿no? Es simplemente una expresión.
Yeah, y súper común.
Sí.
Y la segunda excusa era...
I had to wait ages for the bus and the traffic was terrible.
And the traffic was terrible. So that's a very typical excuse.
It's the same, ¿no? In Spanish.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think they can guess.
And there was also a question that you can ask. ¿Cómo se dice? ¿Has estado esperando mucho tiempo?
Ya, yeah, sí, es lo típico que preguntas, ¿no? Porque en realidad tú sabes que llegas media hora tarde y piensas, bueno, igual he estado esperando media hora, pero puede que también haya llegado tarde la persona, ¿no?
Sí.
It's like your hope, ¿no? That they have been there 5 minutes.
Sí.
Entonces Philip me pregunta, have you been waiting long?
Have you been waiting long?
Have you been waiting long? Have you been waiting long? Have you been waiting long?
Have you been waiting long?
That's always polite to ask if you're a little bit late.
Since the time we arranged to meet, it's 6 o'clock, I've been here, so 1 hour now.
And so Isabel was a little bit angry, no? Because she'd been waiting for an hour.
¿Y yo qué te dije? Te amenacé un poco, ¿no? I threatened you a little bit.
Yes, yeah.
But make sure it doesn't happen again, okay?
Because no, it won't happen again.
If it happens again, you will be in deep trouble.
She said, make sure it doesn't happen again. Make sure it doesn't happen again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, make sure, asegúrate, ¿no?
Yeah.
De que no vuelva a ocurrir.
Yes.
And if it happens again?
If it happens again.
What will happen to you?
You will be in deep... No, you will be in deep trouble. In deep, deep trouble.
Yeah, there is the second version that is very rude.
Yes.
I'm very polite, so you say deep trouble.
Deep trouble, yeah. How would you translate that? Problemas profundas, no?
No, vas a tener problemas serios o vas a tener un problema grave.
Si tienes niños y son muy malos, puedes decirles, you are going to be in deep, deep trouble if you don't do what I say. Yeah. Okay, shall we look at the third conversation? Isn't easy to find, you know. It's really difficult. Are you okay? So, did you hear that excuse? Sorry, I'm late.
I got completely lost.
I got completely lost. I got completely lost. That's a good excuse, no?
Yeah, so, I've used that one before.
Me perdí totalmente, no?
Yeah.
And the second excuse was,
I got completely lost. This place isn't easy to find.
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 No es fácil encontrar este sitio.
Yeah. Este sitio no es fácil encontrar.
This place is not easy to find.
This place isn't easy to find. Isn't.
Isn't easy to find.
Yeah. Can I hear you?
This place isn't easy to find. This phrase isn't easy to say.
Yeah.
Shall we go and get a drink?
Maybe.
I think you've learned the lesson, yes? You're not gonna make me wait. No?
No.
Again?
No.
Never again?
No.
Are you sure?
I'm sure, yeah. I won't be late again.
Mm-hmm. Well, okay, well, I think I'll forgive you this time, okay?
Thank you.
Okay then, this is everything for today. And thank you so much for watching the video. Please share this video if you learn anything. If you like the video, please recommend us to your friends. Come to YouTube, to Facebook, and of course to our website, amigosingleses.com.
Yes. Also, leave us some comments. Do you have any other excuses that you use when you're late? I'm sure you Spanish people have a lot of excuses. You have a long, long list of different excuses. Have you ever arrived late for something very important? And what's the longest you would wait for a friend? Would you wait for 10, 20 minutes or longer? How long would you wait? Are you patient or do you just leave? Let us know in the comments below. And we'll see you in the next video.
See you. Don't be late for the next video.
See you later. Bye.
Sorry.
Hi, Isabel. How are you?
I'm good. What are you going to say?
Long time no see.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
What have you been up to?
Not much, really. Just normal stuff. Going to work. I've just come back from Germany yesterday.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I went there to visit a friend. And yeah, so much better here. It's quite warm. Nice.
It's boiling, yeah, it's lovely. Yeah.
What about you, Philip? How have you been?
Fine, yeah, I've been fine. Yeah? I've not been doing...